Sharon, in what ways do you see yourself as a gift to your husband, Paul?
I believe that being very supportive and complimenting him were some of the most prominent gifts. And even after marriage, helping him in the ministry, in his platform as a music producer, all of this, I feel, pales in comparison to being a woman who knows her worth and value. And being that godly woman who loves and obeys God, I believe there's nothing that beats that gift to your husband or to my husband than anything else that I do for him. I have a question for you. You are newly married. Their 1 year is coming up in May, in about a couple, 2 months. Mm-hmm. Yeah. How has it been so far? Do you see it as happily ever after, happily married ever after?
Yeah, it's been great. It is great. Sam and I made an agreement when we first got together in our first few months of our marriage that we should never go to bed until we had resolved any arguments.
Wow.
And that's been
work.
Helpful. And I realize it's not just between Sam and I. I tried it with my sister. Mm-hmm. We were on the phone and it was late at night. It was an argument. I didn't want to end the call without resolving, and I slept peacefully. So it works for everyone, no matter. This first year of marriage is the year of learning for me, and it's the foundation year. Mm-hmm. So very important year in my life. My marriage will be built upon this year, the foundation that I lay in this year. Sharon, you're a software engineer, just like your husband, and you're equally educated as your husband. Why do you think you should submit to your husband?
Submission is hard, and especially growing up in a very patriarchal culture where men are given more freedom, they're given more exposure, given more abilities or opportunities for them to propel in their social status. And while the women are expected only to excel in their looking after their house and children. But now we see there's so much opportunity for men and women to rise up in their careers and have equal opportunities. Not just that, we see there's gender equality, there's women rights, etc. Mm-hmm. With all that, it's very easy to think that there's no reason for me to listen to my husband. And it's interesting because I heard, especially coming from my country, saying that if the woman is as equally qualified, there's no reason for you to listen to your husband. But that's not true, because we always have to go back to a word which says, submit to your husband. And when it said submit to your husband, it didn't come with an if condition. It didn't say if he deserves, if he's more qualified, if he's much wealthier than you. It didn't even say if he's older to you. For me, submission to my husband is a spiritual leadership. It is not meant on his qualification.
Yeah. That's scary. Submission is not as easy as I thought. Well, us submitting to husbands is as challenging as them loving us, I feel like.
And that's true. But thankfully, the challenging part is given to husbands. So they have the challenging part than us.
I agree.
To love and sacrifice and even die for us.
But I want to share some valuable tips that I received from my teachers about marriage with you all. Not just marriage, your relationship with anyone on this earth, even with God. Mm-hmm. The first thing is to be honest, to be open and honest to God and ask Him for help. Pray. If you don't know how to pray, don't worry. The Holy Spirit will teach you how to pray. And please remember, you're strong. Yes, we fail a lot of times. But remember, there's strength in you. In Proverbs 31:25, it says, she's clothed in strength and dignity. keep loving as you do, keep loving and run to God, to His love, and be consumed by His love. And that way we will be able to be an expression of His love to our spouses, husbands, or everyone around us. And be consistent every day, not just one single time. Every day, go to God and seek help and reach out to Him, and He will reach out to you. Don't forget to forgive. And don't hold any grudges, because love doesn't hold any grudges. And if you hold on to it, it will hold on to you.
Amen.
We're going to close, but remember, if there's one thing that we want to take away from here, is knowing that whether we feel like it or not, whether we are there or not, we are still able to live the godly life and be that godly woman that God has intended us to be until the end of our lives. And we are here to be warriors. We are here to be victorious people. We are here to fulfill this desire or calling that God has given on our lives. And that is also one of the reasons that we meet for women's Bible study every month on a Saturday, is to empower each other, because each of us come with different walks of lives, and we are there studying God's word and also sharing our lives with each other so that we are not alone in this. And we have seen God work miraculously and mightily for each woman.